Welcome to CENGAGE Learning's SAM 2013 Online Tutorial Training Series, Taking a SAM Exam, an installment of the Digital Course Support Services self-training video for students. During this training video, we will quickly review how to log into SAM 2013. We will cover how to see your assignments, how to launch them, how to navigate once you are in an exam, and then what to do when you are done. To begin, you will open SAM 2013. You may want to bookmark the site so that you can easily return to the site to complete your assignments. The URL is http://sam2013.cengage.com. Enter your username and password, and then select Login. Upon logging into SAM, you will arrive at the SAM home screen. To get started, you will select the SAM Assignments link. As soon as you click on the name of your assignment, you will see the assignment details as set by the instructor. He or she may have provided instructions. You may have a specific time limit in which you must complete this assignment. You may be told how many chances you have at each question, how many times you can complete this assignment, as well as how many attempts you have remaining. Once you review this, select the OK button. Before we get to the exam, let's review the SAM navigation from left to right along the bottom. You can see the full list of skills you will be learning by opening the task list. SAM tasks do not have to be done in any particular order. You can either click on a task in the task list to go to that skill, or you can use the left-right question arrows. The task ID is for internal purposes and can also be used if you have any technical support questions. If your instructor has timed the exam, you will see this countdown. If your instructor has set a specific amount of tries per question, you will see that in the attempts remaining. Lastly, when you are done with the exam, you will click the Exit button. Now that you know about the overall navigation of SAM, let's review taking the exam itself. The task you are to perform is written in the maroon box at the bottom of the screen. You will move on to the next question if you get the task correct. If you click on an incorrect ribbon, you will be marked incorrect. If your instructor has allowed multiple attempts, you can try to solve it another way. If you use all of your attempts, you will move on to the next question. You are done with an exam when either you have used all of the allotted time, or if you complete all of the questions. You can select the Exit button at any time to force the exam to end. The most common report used by students is the study guide. To get to the study guide, you will click on the Results link. Your report type should read Exam. The report name should be Study Guide. Click on the radio button next to the assignment, then select the Generate Reports button. Your name, the name of the assignment, the date you completed your assignment, and your score will always be at the top. You can see, on a question-by-question basis, what you performed correctly, incorrectly, skipped, or was not presented. If your instructor has set up SAM to be used with the textbook, you will see the remediation column, providing page numbers in your text to refer back to for more information about that particular skill. If you wish to complete a hands-on learning activity, you can click on the training link to the right to watch, listen, and apply each skill in a helpful way. Thank you for taking the time to review this self-training video. Additional support information can be found at the student support page.